Hello everyone, today we'll see how we can integrate Cinemachine with a DOTS character controller. So let's get to it. If you don't know what Cinemachine is, it's a camera controller. It allows the simple camera controller like we'll see today and follow the character, free look, camera and so on. But it also allows us to do some more advanced stuff like creating cutscenes, making camera transition between gameplay and cutscenes, and so on. So today we'll cover a simple camera controller that will follow the character, be able to orbit around the character, and also to not be occluded by any obstacle, so we always have a line of sight to our character. So it will be something like that. This is a demo scene, one of the many demo scenes that is provided by the Cinemachine package that you can import in the package manager. So here I'm using Cinemachine 3.1.0. And as you can see, I can control this little character. And if I'm pushing the camera near a wall, it's snapping the camera to the wall so that I can still see my character. And on the other wall, it doesn't because it's a different physics layer that is set, so I can avoid that. We'll see how we can reproduce that with the DOTS character controller because here it's all mono behavior. So for that, I imported the character controller 1.1.0 experimental 10. I don't think there is any newer version of that. With the entity 1.2, graphics 1.2, and there should also be the physics, Unity physics 1.2. I've also imported with the character controller the sample that gives me a few prefabs that I can use. And I've set up a scene identical to the Cinemachine scene where I have the two walls, the character controller. So here, it's set up according to the setup guide. So I have my checkerboard, wall section, glass wall section, and then I have the third person player, with the third person controller and orbital camera. And as you can see, this already behaves similarly to the Cinemachine camera controller. When I get occluded, I'm snapping the camera to the wall to be able to see it. And here I did not set it up. I think there can be a setup on the orbital camera. No, in fact, there is not. So already one drawback is that I cannot set up in the orbital camera provided with the camera controller, with the character controller. I cannot set up different layers of physics that would be ignored, such as the glass wall, because we can see through it. So I cannot do that. There is ignore entities filter that I could probably add some entities to it, but it's overall less practical than the Cinemachine one, where I can just set the physics layer on the glass wall to be the transparent VFX. No, sorry, that was the wall. So the glass wall, which is transparent VFX, and that would allow the camera not to be seen. So the next thing I did is to create again an identical scene, and this one is using the same setup in terms of environment as the Cinemachine one and the previous one, and I'm still using the character controller from DOTS, but I'm not using the orbital camera. So for this one to work, I'm actually using a Cinemachine camera, and some of the code I've explained in my DOTS masterclass series, particularly in the animation episodes to animate characters, so the hybrid approach. And I'm reusing the GameObject companion authoring that was a part of that tutorial video. And I'm spawning a freelook camera, so it's the Cinemachine camera setup, pretty much the same thing. There is a few tweaks to the parameters, mainly around the orbital follow. I tweaked a bit the values, but basically it's the same setup as the Cinemachine demo scene. And I've added another script that we will discuss a bit later. the way it's working is that when this entity is instantiated or created, loaded at runtime, when this entity is loaded at runtime, it will spawn the free look camera, so the game object. And I'm also setting another component, which is the tracking target. And for the tracking target, I'm using the camera target that is below the third person controller. And that allows me to do the link with the free look camera. And with this tracking target, I actually have a system. So it's baking the camera target game object. I'm getting the actual entity. So the entity that will be here in this place in the hierarchy. And I'm storing it in a component. And with that component, I'm actually assigning the Cinemachine camera tracking target to the transform component, so the companion game object of that entity, because I've added same thing here on the camera target with a tracking target, and that is just an empty prefab because I need a prefab to instantiate at runtime. If you want more details about how this companion game object work, you can look at my other video in the Dots Masterclass. I will put a link in the description below. But that's how I'm making the link between my Cinemachine setup and the entity I need to follow. So if I enter play mode, and try moving around, you can see that the character is followed by the camera. If I'm putting an obstacle between the camera and the character, I'm snapping the camera to the wall so that I can see it. And in fact, here, this wall is an entities, this one is entities, and this one are entities. So it's working with everything, the ground, the wall, and it's also working here because the wall is in the transparent VFX layer. So I'm not considering it as an occlusion and I'm just leaving the camera where it is. And it's still working with game objects. So here, this cube is a game object. So in fact, yeah, if I'm occluded by this cube, I'm also moving the camera in front of the obstacle to still be able to see my character. So this works because I've created as part of my setup or Cinemachine camera, I've created an additional script. Because normally what allows us to not have the vision occluded is the Cinemachine deoccluder, where you can set the transparent layer. So let's put transparent VFX so that it's the same thing as the sample, but I can choose which layer I'm colliding with and which layer are considered transparent. But this only checks the game object physics, so it's not working against ECS physics. So that's why I've put a simpler version of it that I implemented myself with ECS that will check for the collision with PCS physics object and do the deocclusion just by putting the camera in front. Of course, I don't have all of these options, but I do have the option to choose which layer is colliding. And by choosing default, that's how I'm making it work with the wall section, which is on the default layer, the checkboard stage, which is on default layer. And I can still see through the glass wall section because it's not part of the default layer. So if you want to know how this script is implemented, it will be available to all my Ko-fi supporters, either one-time donation or subscription. I will put it in an article on Ko-fi, and you will need to get into the Discord server to download the file in a private section. So that's how we can work with ECS and Cinemachine. It's not perfect, but it has also advantages. So as we have seen, the orbital camera that comes with the character controller is not a Cinemachine one, so it will not work with all the changing of cutscenes and so on. So you lose all the features of Cinemachine. On the other hand, one of the drawbacks of this method that I've just shown you is that, of course, the deocclusion is less advanced because I just implemented a quick one. And the other drawback is there is a difference in the behavior because the dots character controller relies on the orbital camera to be able to move the character relative to the camera. So here, if I rotate the camera, you can't see it, but if I press forward, it's now moving right because it's not relative to the camera. Whereas if I look at the other scene, so this scene is the third person character controller from dots with the orbital camera. And here, if I press forward, it's moving forward relative to the camera. Same thing if I turn and keep pressing forward, it's moving relative to the camera, as you can see, which is not the case in the other situation. So none of the solutions are perfect. You can choose whichever you prefer. If you have your own character controller, you can maybe even use the same setup, but with your own character controller. You just have to make sure that the Cinemachine setup is following your character controller. And that's it. Let me know what you think, which version you would prefer. Would you like to use the orbital camera controller that comes with dots character controller, or would you rather have the full Cinemachine features with the character controller? Leave a comment down below to let me know. And as usual, you can support me on Ko-fi, which will grant you access to the full file for this project. And you can also use the affiliate link in the description below if you want to benefit from the many sales that are present in the asset store and also support the channel at the same time. Thank you for watching. I will see you in the next video and enjoy your game development.